We seem to be doing a lot of waiting lately. And I don't just mean the usual waiting we've all grown accustomed to, like the DMV or a car repair shop. We're waiting on the vaccine, waiting to see friends and family again, waiting for life to return to normal. If you're like most, waiting or living in that space between what was and what will soon be isn't easy. It can create anxiety, fear, depression. So what do? Easter gives us the answer. On a Saturday more than 2,000 years ago, Jesus' disciples knew the pain of being between what was and what will soon be. They felt the pain of loss, the fear and anxiety of watching their Lord and leader die on a cross. They had no idea what would come next. Little did they know, they are on the cusp of the greatest event in Earth's history. Sunday morning, Christ would walk out of the tomb he was laid to rest in just 2 days before. He would conquer our greatest enemy, death, and give us a living hope of eternal life. While right now, it may seem like a great chasm is before you, or that a high mountain stands in your way, the reality is, you and I have reason to hope. God has something better for us. Jesus, our living hope.
How great the chasm that lay between us, how high the mountain I could not climb. In desperation I turned to heaven and spoke your name into the night. Then through the darkness, your love and kindness tore through the shadows of my soul. The work is finished, the end is written. Jesus Christ, my living hope. Who could imagine so great a mercy? What heart could fathom such boundless grace? The God of ages stepped down from glory to wear my sin and bear my shame. The cross has spoken, I am forgiven. The King of Kings calls me his own. Beautiful Savior, I'm yours forever. Jesus Christ, my has no claim on me. Then came the morning.